Hi, my name's Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show a couple of really nice preview options, shareable link, and send to device. They're great additions to your workflow and help with collaboration and mobile testing. Shareable link is used to easily send previews to the approvers on your project to let them see your work in a browser with all the final interactivity and animation. All you do is pull down preview from the menu and select Get Shareable Link. You'll need to sign into your Google account. Then it takes a second or two to generate the link. And now you have three options. Click the link to preview in your default browser, copy link, and cancel closes the dialog. Then the way I use it is to open up my email, compose a message, and paste that link. Then it's easy for those people to check out your work, proof the functionality, and send their comments or approval. If you're working with a responsive file, then you'll be asked to select a specific size for previewing. I'll make this file responsive, then share a link again. And I'll see an extra step where I select one of these sizes first. Then the rest is the same. One thing to note is if you make a change or forget something, then you'll need to generate another link, because each shared link is a one-time snapshot of your creative at a given time. It won't be refreshed when you continue editing. And finally, there are some restrictions on this feature. Only ads are supported, not these others. And of these ad types, only banner and interstitial are fully supported. Expandables are limited, and AMP is not supported. Of the environments, all these are supported, except non-Google ads. And one last limitation is seeing your sample data in dynamic ads. If you need that, it's best to generate share links in the publishing environment UI, since Studio DV360 and Google Ads all support that. When creating a share link for dynamic ads the way I'm showing, the ad will always use No Sample Data from the dynamic panel. The workaround is to simply include placeholder content for your dynamic elements. For example, this data-driven template for displaying Video 360 comes with placeholder content for all the dynamic elements, and we can see that in the dynamic panel switching between sample data and no sample data. This logo container has a placeholder image set for its source. If it didn't, we would just have an empty box. Same with these text elements. When we create a share link, it's the no sample data state that's being shown. The other thing I want to show is how to preview your work on a device like a mobile phone. This is handy when designing mobile ads and you want to test or get a feel for the real experience on your own phone rather than the browser's device emulator. This does take a little setup and I'll walk you through. The first thing is to use your device to download and install the Creative Preview app from the Play or App Store. The first time you open the app, you'll be guided through a simple setup where you allow access, select your Google account, sign in, and agree to terms of service. The next thing you'll see is the Creative screen, and that means you're ready. Now back in Google Web Designer, in the Preview dropdown, select Send Preview to Device. If you're not already signed in, you'll be prompted to log into your Google account, and that's the same one we use to set up the phone. If you don't see your device or sign-in screen, then make sure you're not already signed in to a different account up here in the menu bar. If you are, just sign out, then back in again and choose the correct account. Once you're signed in correctly, you'll see your device name in this menu, and you just select it. Now on your phone in the Creative Preview app, you'll see your file name at the top of the list. Click it and you'll see your preview. Now you can interact with it and make sure your gestures and events work. Certain formats like Swirl and Parallax require a different preview environment. Here's a Parallax ad and I'll send it to my device. When I select it on my phone, instead of seeing the preview, I'm shown the info screen where I choose the second preview option, Mobile Web, which opens a web page. And now I can scroll to see the ad in action. That does it for the preview options, shareable link, and send to device. Thanks for watching.